Hello everyone, hope you all are fine, and this week we will be discussing only on the quick examination which is already over and the upcoming examination, that is based on chapter 1 and 2. Today our discussion will be based on mock test 1. Some of you could not give the test, maybe certain technical errors were there, network issues were there, but now by the time I hope you all have understood the problems that you have faced, and in the upcoming examination you will not be having such problems anymore. Now let us go and discussions of this. And one more thing, just to tell that do not worry about this. This was just a trial run, so that in the unit test you do not face such problems, so that these mock tests were taken. So don't worry that I have not submitted my question paper, was not submitted, any problem will be there or not. So you all have seen the question paper. Let us discuss the question numbers, questions. The first question was of I think it was a multiple choice question, and first question was ratio of the mass of hydrogen is to oxygen. Hydrogen is 2 and oxygen is 16, so actually it is 1:8, so this will be the answer, 1:8. Second is number of carbon atom in carbonate radical. Carbonate radical symbol is CO3 2-, so we have 1 carbon atom in carbonate radical. Third is, if blue vitriol is heated, what is the change in the color? Blue vitriol, you know that it is pentahydrated, 5 water molecules are there per molecule of copper sulfate. So if blue vitriol is heated, we get it white color. The water molecule escapes out, so answer will be white. Fourth is type of reaction when iron reacts with dilute hydrochloric acid. It's a displacement reaction. Fifth is variable valency. It is shown by TEN, that is stannous. SN, it shows SN2+, SN4+, stannous and stannic. Then second question is fill in the blanks. The new first question was valency of iron in FeCl3. Write only 3. Remember, valency is the combining capacity. Here we do not put plus and minus. Charge is not asked. Valency is asked. So once the valency is asked, means you need to write only the number. Valency as combining capacity, it will never be represented as plus or minus. So valency is 3, only 3, no plus, no minus. Second is reaction between iron and chlorine. It's a direct combination reaction. Third is short form, that was symbol. Fourth is atom that is displaced when iron react with HCl, hydrogen atom. And the fifth answer, that is symbolic representation of a molecule, is a formula or chemical formula. Both are correct. Third is, you need to write the valency. Again, valency will only be number, plus minus will not be accepted. Aluminium is 3, oxygen 2, sulfate 2, and lithium is 1. Fourth was numerical. There were 3 numericals. Each numerical carries 2 marks. First one was molecular weight of calcium nitrate. Calcium nitrate formula is CaNO3 whole 2. So you need to calculate molecular weight. 40 plus, it is 14 into 2 plus 16 into 6. So if you do the calculations, the answer what is coming is 164. So you do the calculation, 40 plus 28 plus 96, 4, 164. That is the answer. Unit not necessary. You can give AMU or you just can leave it. Next is percentage of oxygen in carbon dioxide. That was the second numerical. So you need to calculate the carbon dioxide molecular weight first. That is 44. Okay, you will write only the answer. So 44. And oxygen is here 32 because it's CO2. So 32 by 44 into 100. This, and the answer that is coming, 72.727. That is the answer. 72.727 is the answer. This is the percentage. You need to write only the answer. Third question was percentage of water in blue vitriol. Blue vitriol CuSO4.5H2O. Similarly, you calculate the molecular weight. The molecular weight that will come is 248.5, and the water molecule is 90. So 90 by 248.5 into 100, the percentage that is coming 36.217. So it can be, you can write 36.22 as well. So you need to write only the answer, calculation you do in the paper. So that's all about the answers. Now next day we will discuss some more from this chapter. Take care and